The stories of 25 bold men who were determined to realize their dreams is a kind of roadmap for the next generation. The book, Suited for Success, highlights their inspirational stories to encourage others. It's a collaboration presented by the founder of the nonprofit organization That Suits You, Pk Kersey, who's here today along with Daryl Edmonds, the CEO and founder of Friday is Tie Day, Inc., and motivational speaker and author, Dr. Oliver T. Reed. Thank you all for being with us today.
Thank you.
Welcome back.
Thank you.
Why don't you, we'll start by you explaining to everybody what That Suits You is.
That Suits You basically is a nonprofit organization where we collect suits and ties, and we give them to young men who may never have had the opportunity to wear suits. We give them to men coming home from prison. We give them to homeless shelters. We give them to men who have that need of wearing a suit, maybe for an interview, maybe it's for a job, maybe it's for graduation or prom. So we try to give them that suit so that they can go to the next level in their life.
Yeah, it is such a simple idea, great organization. You've
Thank
been
you.
Doing this, what you told me, since 2013.
Correct.
And so why did you decide to create this book, to gather these stories and put them out there? Why was that important to you?
Well, you know, I'm big on social media, and I see women all the time. They have big forums, they have conferences, they have so many things going on with their collaborative efforts, and I admire that, but I didn't really see that from the male point of view. Mm-hmm. So, you know, I got some guys together who I know some awesome men who are doing some great things, so I said, listen, let me put this book together so we can share these stories. So we're giving them suits, we're giving them ties, but let's also give them stories. Let's give them history of what it takes to succeed. You know, maybe a different path, maybe someone started here, maybe someone started here, but what did they have to do to survive? What did they have to do to be successful? And I believe these stories in the book tell that story. And it's like representation.
Yeah.
A young man could read this and say, wow, they did something I know I can do. I got a suit now, I got a tie, and I've got some motivational stories that can help me to, you know, when times get harder. Listen, they had tough times, but mm-hmm. they still put it together so that they can succeed. So these stories, I believe, are powerful, and it really will make an impression on young men. Not just young men, anyone who has a dream.
Yeah, I was really inspired by them because one of the things I noticed I said to you guys before the interview started is that Dr. Reed's story and Daryl's story,
right.
they really have totally different beginnings, but they end sort of the same place, successful, and giving back and sharing that knowledge.
Yes.
I'm gonna start with you, Daryl. I love your story because it was very familiar to me.
Yeah.
You described in the book the the Sundays, going to church every Sunday, meeting at your family's homes, and just how that fed you. And I love that story. Talk to me a little bit about your organization, which is Friday is Tie Day. It's a mentoring
Yes,
group.
It is. Yeah, so it's a mentoring program. And one of our things is our guys wear ties to school on Friday. Well, most of them do, right? So that's our thing. But what we also do is we meet monthly. We have discussions and engagement sessions around different things. And we also do, our goal is to set them on a course for post-high school success.
Mm-hmm.
Right?
And the tie, why the tie?
The tie just seemed to be a piece to me that was central. I remember my father teaching me how to tie a tie. And I also remember going into his closet to steal ties and wear ties to church.
Because that made you a man.
It made me a man, but my father.
In your mind then.
Yeah, and my father was a big man, so I had to always tie the tie a few times around to get it to fit me, because he had extra long ties. So, but that was just something that was just really significant to me, all the lessons he taught me around that. You know, how to wear a tie, how to wear a bow tie, how to wear a pocket square, what a collar bar is, a tie bar is, all those types of things about being a gentleman he taught me.
Yeah.
And it taught me about being respectful. He taught me stories about his father who worked in a naval yard in Philadelphia. He wore a plastic black bow tie to work every day
yeah.
with his uniform. So just those things kind of stuck with me.
Mm-hmm. And in your story that you mm-hmm. share in the book, mm-hmm. why, I mean, I think it said a whole lot about who you are
yeah.
and where you came from.
Mm-hmm. I think it was a part of me was struggling initially doing a mentoring because I'm mentoring kids from situations that aren't like mine.
Mm-hmm.
And I had a child tell me once, and I'll never forget it. He said, but you're not real. He said, you're not real to me. You're not like the men in my life. You're not like the men in my neighborhood. You're not what we see. And I said, wow, that like kind of blew my mind. And I'm like, well, does that discredit me from being an effective mentor? Because I didn't have some of the same experiences. And we know those things help. But I also think it means a lot when you have models that you can see
yeah.
to actually show you the right way. And what more can I do to be that model to these young men? So it just kind of reaffirmed me in my upbringing, everything that I learned and everything that I was taught, that, you know, this is the path that God has set me on, and I'm going to be all right doing it.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
You know?
Yeah.
And Dr. Reed, your story, almost the exact opposite. of Daryl. So you, your father was not in your life, and then you unfortunately had a stepfather that was really not anyone you want in a home with a child.
Yes,
quite frankly. So, and you shared that in the book. Obviously, not a reflection on who you have become as a man. Talk to me about why you wanted to share that story with people.
Right. I like to consider myself as a relationship architect, builder of relationships, and connect people to solutions and solutions to relationships. And I felt that in this, I needed to be very transparent. This was something when PK brought the opportunity to me, it was a situation where I wanted to be very authentic and share a story I'd never shared before. Mm. And what hit home was my father's rejection. And it set me on a course to kind of ruin a lot of relationships that I was going to engage in. My father's first words to me was, "You're not my son." And so with that echoed. I always say that silence is what could have been said without effort. He said the words, but he was silent and estranged for about 30 years.
Yeah. And how did you finally stop letting that be the dominant voice in your head?
Yes. It was funny. I remember being married for the second time and actually getting a call where my dad had called my mother instead of calling me. So instantly my ego kicked in and said, he wants to reconnect with me, but he couldn't even call me. Mm-hmm. So I was like, I'm not going to speak to him. And my wife said to me, "That's still your father." I said, "No, he's a sperm donor. He's not my father." Mm-hmm. And she said, "You can go up and you can come down, but he'll still be your father." So I really got ahead when I was confronted with it again, and I thought I was over it. I had my own children by then, successful business, thought I was all together until I was faced with it again.
Yeah. But you did the work.
Yes.
And now you've got a consulting firm, I Am a Solution.
Yes.
And talk to me a little bit about what you focus on.
Yeah, I focus on building relationships, helping businesses grow, and also writing coaching, expressing literary. It's a safe haven for our young men to be able, and women, to be able to write it out, all the pain.
And even if, as you listen to them tell their very different stories, is this what you had in mind to put out there for others to read and see?
Pretty much. I mean, most of the successful stories we hear about black men are usually athletes or actors or something. So, but I wanted to tell the story that we see every day that's not being told. So we have firemen, we have pastors, we have mentors, we have people who have their own company, we have bankers. So some typical everyday individuals, but we also have people that are anchors. We also have some celebrities. So it depends. What path do you want to take? Yeah. You're going to find struggles. You're going to have obstacles. How do you handle them? And sometimes you need just something to look at and say, wow, this is how this person handled this. Yeah. Or this person started this deep down and they still made it up. So it's just, I believe it's a representational book that people can read and say, wow, I can achieve no matter what the obstacle, no matter what my dream. And there's some excellent stories with, like you said, transparency. Yeah. Like there's some stories in there that make you cry, some stories make you laugh, but it's stories that real life, and it shows that no matter where you are, you can succeed.
And even in the book, you give a few things that you need to do. Get up, get yourself up early. It sounds simple.
Right, right.
But there are people that don't have the role models in their life telling them to do that or taking the time to do that.
Right, right.
It really is one of those things you go, my goodness, why hadn't this been done before? The book is Suited for Success, and where can we find it?
You can go to my website, that suits you, and you can find the link if you want to purchase it. So it's on Amazon online and Barnes & Noble's online. You can purchase it there as well.
Okay, and Friday is tiday.org,
yes,
your organization, and yours, your onesolutioncoach.com,
yes,
right? Thank you guys for being with us this afternoon. Nice to meet you.
Thank you for having us.
Continued success, and I know you're coming back. Thank you.
Sandra Bookman and Here and Now. We'll be right back.